Hello, I'm Mr. Harnagiri, retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. In Jesus, what comes out of your own mouth, that matters, because the gospel rests in your heart and not in the dead letters of the books, which we call letters or law, scriptures. So that's why Luke 16, verse 16 says that law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So John the Baptist had the scripture. No more after that one. After that one, we are led by Holy Spirit. And in Holy Spirit, we learn gospel through logical reasoning. Holy Spirit is common sense. So using common sense, we do intuition, logical reasoning, and we brew logo over our heart. And then we preach gospel from our own mouth, which is called drinking the blood of Christ. So listening to Jesus, what he has said, is eating the flesh of Jesus. Take it to your heart, digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning, and then preach gospel from your own mouth, as from your own mouth with authority, and you can explain people from logical point of view. And that is what Jesus was doing. He was explaining to them scripture. The root of the top root of the scripture is oral Torah. Without the top root, the tree is dead. Scripture is dead. So Jesus had the top root, oral Torah, when he was preaching or teaching the gospel, explaining to them the parable, the scripture. He was doing so with great authority because he knew the top root. So top root here is called logical reasoning, is logo, which is oral Torah. So here I'm telling you because some people address Jesus as Lord, which is quite common. And this was done by Pope. Pope is Antichrist. So in the name of Pope, in the name of Christ Jesus, this Pope was persecuting people, killing people, imposing his own view. If you don't agree, he will burn it, you at stake. And that time is gone. Now you can express yourself. So Lord has slaves, and slaves are not allowed into the house. Whereas the father, he has sons, and sons are allowed. They can come and go out as they like it, because they are the heir. They are the owner of the property. Slave is not the owner of the property, he is just a laborer. John the Baptist, he was the Lord of the once-born students, which were called disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural boys by teaching them the moral of Moses. So then it bring a kingdom of heaven on earth. So here is the two concepts. John the Baptist, he held the scripture, and scripture is of Yahweh. And the root of the scripture is oral Torah, which is his word. So here we have He is the Lord of the nature. And here is Christ Jesus, who is the Son of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So he himself is the Son. He makes other people son as well. So they can enter into the house without any problem, sit at the table. Whereas the slaves, they are outside singing the praises of our supernatural Father. So those 70 outer circle laborers, They had Lord Yahweh. Yahweh was the Lord. Whereas the 12 inner circle laborers, they were the son of the Most High. They had no law, but they had Father, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So this concept of Father is clearly stated here. In my book, give you concept of Christianity in a nutshell. So, menorah, the three candles here, three here, social, economical, political appear. Three holy, three evil. That's why David's cross upside down. So these are of Yahweh, pots created by Yahweh. And the soul in them is of Elohim, which is the middle candle. Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, the same thing. Nature. So Yahweh is the Lord of the nature. And our supernatural Father is the Father of our souls. The soul inside us is originated from our Father, God. So this is our supernatural Father, and these are natural, pots are natural. Natural Father of water, born of water, born of spirit. Now, this one, and now it will become clear that when you address Jesus as Lord, then you put him in the kingdom of Satan, because he came to serve and not to lord over people. So these people calling Pope as Lord is calling Pope as Satan, because we don't need Pope in Christ Jesus. He set us free of all these man people. That's why the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn from top to bottom, that you have a direct approach to God. No intermediary. Here I have something I have written. In Jesus, we have one Father that have sons allowed to enter the house as they like it, and they inherit the property of the Father. Whilst the lords have slaves, and the slaves are not allowed into the house, but kept outside as the 70 outer circle laborers being trained in the name of John the Baptist were kept away. Jesus only invited the 12 inner circle to close to near to him, and they learned the gospel through them, the oral Torah. Unless you become the son of God, which is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., our supernatural Father, you cannot have redemption or salvation. Like Father, like Son. Son of God is Christ, and not the Christians of the book. So you need to have Christ in your heart before you can preach gospel. So in India, St. Thomas went there. He was known as Christ Thomas. And those who his laborers, they were not known as Christians, but they were known as Christ. And they used to be honest people. I went to that part of India, and a local priest, told me many things. So the Christians of the book, the Bible, which is the Jewish leaven, forbidden by Jesus, as gospel gets written over your own heart and not in ink on paper, as the scriptures, letters were in the past. That's why law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. No letter and no scripture. Transgression against the moral law is called sin. So anybody who's in the churches who talk about sin, he is Antichrist. In churches, we talk about blasphemy, and then we expose that blasphemy in the context of the oral Torah or His word. So with gospel, we expose the hypocrites. Then we can tell them that you are a hypocrite. Like these people, like Queen, you know, who is the head of the Church of England. And people over there, they worship her, they go to her church, and they are very proud that we belong to Church of England. The Church of England is headed by Queen. Queen is head of Mammon. And when her soldiers die fighting in the expansion of the empire, she will tell her priest, proclaim it that they died to glorify God. So, yes, many sent off in churches, and other in one church in local in Reading, they had this thing that the soldier died to glorify God. They said, no, it's not right. So they took it off from that one and put it and away. As soon as they took it off, there was hue and cry among the people that, hey, our soldiers who were died in World War I, World War II, their glory had been taken off from the church. But they said, oh, we are kept it in a safe place, don't worry. So people, you know, not many people have common sense. Not many people have, which is Holy Spirit. And so without Holy Spirit, you are led astray, and you are led by ego. So these people in Britain, white skin, they think the black people have no brains. So they can twist the thing as they like it. And the beauty is this, you know, that their own people, they don't support us. They also twist it. I have a very bad experience with the ombudsmen, and all of them twisted the fact. I got no pleasure out of them. So there you are, the word is quite funny. Don't worry, our Father knows it. And those people who deceive others, they have to answer to God. And righteousness is of God, and which is unrighteousness is of Satan. And Satan is super bastard fanatic devil. John 8 verse 44. That is what Jesus told in the temple, that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils, and they took stones to hit him. So this gospel is bitter. So you have to carry your own cross to preach it. Our Father God blesses everyone alike.